Hey guys, Andrew here, and welcome back to an episode of Stories Untold! When we last left off, we did The House Abandoned, and now we're gonna do The Lab Conduct. House Abandoned was already spooky scary skeletons enough, so let's try this one. Sure it won't be scary at all. Sure it'll be just fine. Sometimes you may need to look beyond the screen to progress. I will not look into my soul to progress through a game that, no, just not gonna happen. Is it the same intro sequence? Okay, so it's the same opening sequence every time. Can I skip this? No. Okay. Well, I guess we'll be seeing this intro every single time we play. So that's a good sign. It's a good sign of a fun time. The house abandoned. It's like it just never stops following me for some reason. Okay.
This is subject 12-19-86-23, new session entry. We have myself, Dr. Alexander, leading, assisted by Dr. Williams, and in the lab itself, our volunteer, Mr. Asian. We have artifact 23 in the chamber, recovered from crash site B. At the moment it appears inert, showing no signs of activity. Mr. Asian, instructions for each stage will come through to your terminal, and we need you to follow them exactly. Now, some of this may be unfamiliar, so always reference the manual on your terminal for guides on calibration and procedure. Once you've calibrated equipment to match our brief, the green light will flash, allowing you to trigger the experiment. One last thing. Ensure that any equipment non-essential to the current experiment is switched off. You cannot proceed until your calibration matches ours. When you're ready, let's bring this back.
Okay. Experiment 1, internal analysis. Subject J1986 MEM is enclosed in solid outer layers. X-ray the artifact to determine its internal structure. Okay. That one? Oh, I can zoom in. Huh, right-click zooms in. Whoa. Okay. Let's see, electromagnetic spectrum. So, manual. X-ray. Okay, so electromagnetic spectrum, X-ray, required apparatus, camera. Monitor set to X-ray, charge, CC86 X-ray device, TV, input modes, R3, IR, XR. Okay. Help. Ah, okay, so tab rolls over to the test chamber. Okay, so let's go back to X-ray. Let's see, CC86 on the X-ray device. What? Charge CC86 X-ray device. How do you charge? Okay. Do I see anything that says CC86? No. So it needs to be R3, IR, and XR. R3, IR, XR. Okay. Can't really tell what the other stuff is. Oh, CC86. Charge ready. Okay. Monitor set to X-ray. Okay, so monitor is set to X-ray and charge X-ray device. Okay. Okay, well, it's on. So now what? Nothing else is on. Alright, I guess I'll continue. 2. Concentrated light laser. Acquired apparatus. LZR2 light generator set to a set wavelength. Monitor set to RGB. Wait, what? No, shouldn't I be... How do you... Oh, wait, help. At the chamber, use your mouse cursor to select interact. Tab roller test chamber. Press the keys back into the top menu. Move between pages. Okay, well, this experiment is ready. How do I... I'm pretty sure. Okay. Monitor set to X-ray. It is. Charged CC86 X-ray device. It is. Pretty sure it's charged. Charge ready. Yep. Charge ready. It is on XR. Okay. Oh. Awaiting X-ray data. I guess I had to turn that on. This is kind of weird. Do I need to press that button? Oh.
Okay, good work. The X-ray is coming through now. There's no visible damage to the surrounding organic material, and no signs of activity either. All output is flatlined. Okay, let's begin.
Okay. Experiment complete. Enter receive new experiment task. Experiment 2, surface reaction attempt. Demonstrate the effects of laser light on the object. Try using a low-powered red laser to begin with. Manual. Concentrated laser. Cryo apparatus. Laser 2 light generator set wavelength. Red is 650 nm. What is that? What was it called? The laser 2 light generator. 650. Laser 2, 650. Okay. And then set monitor to RGB. Okay.
No reaction from first stage. Let's try high frequency.
Okay, well that was easy. Surface reaction attempt. Demonstrate the effects of laser light on the object. Ooh, use the green laser. So what was green? 510. All right. Try it again.
Okay, we have a reaction of some sort here, a weak signal. Let's keep going. Increase again.
You sure about that? I think it's getting kind of... I don't know. It looks like a heart. Use the blue laser. What's the blue laser? 455. All right. Let's 455 it up. Try it again. See what happens.
Well, would you look at that? It seems we have a pulse.
What?
Rhythm is stable. There's no activity registering in the core. It's possibly damaged. Let's push further.
It's possibly damaged? Wait, it's like literally a heart without a body beating. What is the blood? What is anything? That's not how anything in the human body works. Okay. Let's see. Resonant frequency. Test the acoustic resonance properties of the object. Begin with generating a 250 Hz sine wave with amplifier set to gain 1. So, acoustic rendering. Cryo apparatus. Signal generator, set frequency and waveform. Amplifier, set gain. Alright, what is any of this? So, I'm gonna turn you off, don't need you anymore. Boop, and... right? And what did you want the frequency at? 250 hertz sine wave with the amplifier gain set to 1. Assuming this is the amplifier. Is that the amplifier? I can't really tell what that is. And this is like on the highest graphical settings too, and you couldn't like get it just to be a little bit sharper for me? Okay, maybe not that. Frequency. Well, what did you want the frequency at? 250 hertz. Oh my geez. How high does this thing go? Oh, I can just hold it. So 250 is what I need. All right, and with a sine wave amplifier gain set to 1. Amplifier display. Ah, okay. So that was the thing I saw. It needs to be a sine wave and needs to have amplifier set at 1. So that's all I need, right? Turn off the TV. Yes. What? Okay. Didn't say I need the TV on, and it said to turn off everything that I don't need to follow through with their exact experiment. So what am I missing here? Is it this thing? That's 5. Where's 1 at? That's 10. Come on. Oh my god. That's really hard to mimic. Okay. Good to go?
It's not much of a response. Updating the experiment now.
All right, what more do you want, dude? Let's see here. Test the acoustic resonance, increase the frequency to 500 hertz, sine wave, and amplifier gain set to 5. You said 500? Sorry, swivel my chair again. 500 hertz. My jeezum. And this needs to be at 5. 5, and just 500, I guess. So, oh, I think I can kind of hear a whine. All right, do it.
Seeing some fluctuations in activity. Should we increase to the risk of damage? What about level 2? Okay, we're gonna push further. I'm running out of time. Let's switch around.
What? Hold on a second. Is this a good idea? I'm a little concerned. Switch to square wave. Okay. So you want a square wave. Oh, that's not looking good, dude. Hey,
we're seeing good activity on this side. Seeing definite spikes in movement. I know this might seem uncomfortable or dangerous, but you need to trust us.
Do I? Test the acoustic resonance properties of the object. Maintain the gain at 5 and the square waveform. Bring the waveform frequency up to 1 kilohertz. That's a little high, dude. Are you sure? I don't think it's supposed to be that high. I mean, you're the boss, but man, that doesn't sound. That's not a good sound. Yeah, that's definitely not a good sound. We might have a problem here. Yeah. Oh boy. Oh, it exploded.
Full activity registering. We did it. Can you hear us?
You did it?
Excellent progress. You're doing great. Now we need you to stay calm and try to relax as we go through these next steps. We're going to attempt to alleviate some of this discomfort.
Okay? What discomfort? Of blowing up a heart by frequencies? The protective casing is off. Proceed to drill the surface. This is 4. Drill press. Switch drill on. Ensure all other equipment except the camera and TV are switched off. When ready, trigger sync master as normal to begin drill instruction. All right. Scoop, de-doop, and doop. Oh.
How do you feel? Don't be scared. We have the situation under control.
Okay.
Take a few moments, and when you're ready, we'll continue.
I mean, it's fine. Why would I be scared? Because the lights went out? I mean, I'm an adult. Make contact with the artifact. Open the test chamber. What? No, wait, what? That's a terrible idea. Use safety goggles and gloves at all times. Do not leave the container unattended during experimentation. It is extremely dangerous to handle any items within the container. Please ensure your next of kin is updated to HR. As per agreement, follow all instructions exactly. Okay. What the fuck is that thing? Also, the drill clearly didn't go through. What?
It's time to remember.
Wait, what's going on? Oh, okay. Ow. That was a lot of stuff, thank you.
You're a proxy now. You have a connection to the entity's inner core.
What? Okay. It's not creepy at all. Oh. Wow. All right. Well, thank you for that visual. Floating eye. Memory retrace. You wake up in the cryptopod. Struggling against gravity, you force yourself up. Impact into the planet's surface has torn a hole in the ship hull. Poisonous.
Remarkable. You can navigate its memories. Use the computer. Work your way through.
Okay. Poisonous atmosphere spills into your craft. You are in grave danger. You have to get out of here. Get out. Memory action unavailable. Command not recognized. Look around. The craft is broken beyond repair. There's wreckage all around. An airlock door is locked tight, and the computer terminal adjacent blinks. Check computer. Use computer. You tap the screen, and the airlock door sputters to life, slowly opening with a horrendous noise. The ship powers down to silence, having spent the last of its reserves. Enter airlock. Go to airlock.
This organ was taken from what we think was the leader. These memories are different. They're not like the others. There's more detail here. Less hazy. Lean in. See what else it hides.
Oh, good. All right, well, let's go. Okay. Yeah, I'm really starting to love that. You squeeze through the damaged airlock and fall to your knees on the ground next to your vehicle. Every breath brings pain to your chest. You look around and you are surrounded by mangled metal.
This is incredible. Are we information. Please continue.
Bright lights pour through every gap in the surrounding wreckage. Okay. Sounds great. Look around. A crash site. Smoke billows from the downed ship. Exterior lights flicking on and off. Wreckage surrounds you. Looking upwards, you see unfamiliar star patterns. Get up. Alright. Let's see. Look at stars. You don't recognize any of the star patterns above you. Look at crash site. Look at lights. The lights are blinding. You make out silhouettes, but you need to move some of the surrounding wreckage for a better view. Move wreckage. Oops, did I spell that wrong? Move wreckage. There we go. With every ounce of your remaining strength, you move away enough of the wreckage for you to carefully crawl through. The lights that surround you now attack your senses. Cover eyes. The light that surrounds you now attacks your senses. Hide? Let's see. Look at light. You squint at the light, trying to shield your visor lens at the same time. It is a circle of artificial lights set up around you to illuminate the crash site in the darkness. Behind them, an army of people, all staring. One figure steps out, a silhouette, and walks towards you. Look at silhouette. The silhouette is bipedal and bulky. Some sort of mask covers its face. It beckons you to approach. Walk toward it. Or walk forward. Approach. Okay. What the fuck? Go to silhouette.
Your heart rate is elevated, but you're doing well. For what it's worth, very few of our test subjects ever make it this far.
What?
You should be proud of yourself.
No, what? I didn't sign up to be killed by a... whatever this is. Alright, here it comes again. Okay. Oh, science and stuff. Oh. Okay, woo. Oh, that is a good feeling in my heart, my eyes. Memory retrace. We awake. The room is silent only for the quiet hum of equipment and occasional machine beep. Your touch isn't yours. We are all as one. We move together in unison. Move together. Let's see. Look around. We are in a bed, in a small and artificially lit room with a single door. There is some sort of writing pinned on the wall. Adjacent is a display monitor, with wires that drape across the room and into our chest. With the wires draped across the room and into our chest, they have tortured us. Remove wires.
What just happened? What's that alarm? There's been a disconnection in quarantine lab 15.
What?
What's going on?
We yank at the wires protruding from our chest. Together, we all scream in pain. This action sets off an alarm, echoing loudly down the adjacent corridor. Get up. Leave room?
Stop. Specimen 20 has left lab 15. It's on the move. My god. That vision. It's not a memory. It's happening right now. Mr. Asian, I need you to stop what you're doing, please.
I mean, no. You're gonna kill me, so out of spite, I'm just gonna keep going and see where this leads us. Sounds like fun. Okay. All right. Well, that's interesting. Ooh. Yeah, that never stops being fun. I see where the epilepsy warning that showed up in the beginning of this game comes into play. That's, whew. If I didn't have epilepsy, I certainly do now. Through the door, we find ourselves in an empty room with a device on the table. It looks familiar. They don't know how it works, but this host does. The door closes behind us and a lock clamps shut. We are alone together. Look around. It is some sort of preparation room. There are markings on more sheets, with a door and a window on one side. The door we came through has been locked shut, and the other door has an orange alarm light above it. In the center of the room, a table holding only a small device taken from your It's My Our Ship. Take small device. Grab small device. Open door. Look at table. A metal and wood table. On top, a small device taken from the ship. Look at small device. It was an access code terminal for a wide connection, allowing commanders to commandeer other hosts. Only you, I, we have access to these codes. It's time to use them. Use codes.
What is that? We haven't seen that before. What is it doing? It's using the tool we recovered from the crash site. It's in our systems. It's sending something across the network.
What? It is?
Mr. H, please. We deeply regret what we have put you through, but please understand it was for the greater good.
Huh.
No more. Rebelling now could be catastrophic. You don't know what this might do to you in the long run.
I don't, but at the same time, I'm very curious, and I also can't match these. Ah, I can do this, though. Where is that one? Wait, what is it supposed to be? I am actually confused as to what we're trying to do right now. Because it looks like you're trying to tell me this, and then this, and then this. Is that what you want? That's what that is right there, isn't that? That's exactly what that is. But this one wants something else. It wants, like, a symbol that I don't have access to. I just don't have access to that symbol. What is the symbol that you want? Shit. Can I do any of the same symbols that are showing up on that side? I cannot. So what if I just change it to one of every symbol? Okay, that worked. What? What is happening? Oh.
They're all free. They're converging. It's over.
What the hell are these things? That's a lot of them. Are these the aliens? Oh. Okay. But why, though? I guess we'll just put our face inside of one and see what happens.
Mr. H, please, don't do this. We mean you. We mean them no harm. Please, don't do something you regret. Wait.
Wait, what?
One day, Mr. H, this will haunt you.
Okay, well, I guess that's the end of that episode. Weird, spooky stuff. I don't know why there's a human heart in the beginning at all. I guess that was for visual reasons, to be like, ooh, spooky heart. But that story wasn't as gripping, I guess. Because it had the same exact twist, which the twist was like, it's happening in real time. So, like, I'm hoping that's not your entire twist for the whole thing, because it's not really a twist once it happened before. Now it's just, like, storytelling. Now it's just repetition. But, I mean, it's still okay. It was interesting. I mean, you had to do a lot of things and set a lot of dials, and that was, it was hit or miss. Depends on how fun, you know, you have doing that, trying to figure that kind of stuff out. But, yeah, so I guess on to the station process will be next. So I'm going to go ahead and say thank you guys for watching. If you like what you see, go ahead and click subscribe. Otherwise, leave a comment in the comment section below. Tell me the worst stories untold player you've ever seen before. As always, thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time, and bye!